Toyota Corolla Cross SUV is now only offered with a hybrid drivetrain, but Toyota has not ruled out producing a fully electric version. Well, we're going to try to find out about if Honda's HRV is better than the Corolla, and what's the plan for Toyota to run its EV masterstroke. For all these questions, you need to make sure you watch this whole video, and let us know if it's worth the drive. So fasten your seatbelts, and without any further delay, let's go on a long drive together. According to Toyota Australia's VP of Sales and Marketing, Sean Hanley, an electric version of the Corolla Cross could join the gas and electric-powered SUV shortly. He opined that you can't rule out the opportunity for Corolla to transition to electric power. To better serve our customers' needs at present, we have introduced a hybrid variant. Like Hyundai's IONIQ lineup, Toyota has its BZ or Beyond Zero sub-brand dedicated solely to electric vehicles, and the BZ4X SUV will be the first model to be sold in Australia under this name. In collaboration with Subaru, the maker of the Solterra, that allowed for the creation of a model that will compete with the popular Hyundai IONIQ 5, Kia EV6, and Tesla Model Y in the all-electric, mid-size family SUV market. However, Mr. Hanley stated that the lack of an EV option for the new Corolla Cross was due only to product segmentation, just more work on the products. Right now, they're working on releasing the first BEV, the BZ, but perhaps in the second half of next year. Stay tuned for that, he said. Also, development of the vehicle began long before the current surge in popularity of electric cars, since the Corolla Cross was originally unveiled for international markets 2 years ago. Mr. Hanley, however, noted that the Corolla Cross lineup had a hybrid option that may be as successful as the hybrid versions of the Corolla hatchback sedan, Camry, RAV4, and Kluger. Many other automakers like Hyundai, Kia, Mercedes-Benz, and BMW have already developed electric vehicles, whereas Toyota has been criticized for being slow to market. In addition, the introduction of Chinese manufacturers like BYD with the Atto 3 and MG with the ZS-EV has cut the entry price into the market even further. A recent rumor, however, says that moving ahead, Toyota would focus more on EVs, abandoning its existing rollout plan in favor of bringing more electric cars to market and doing it more quickly. The inner workings of an electric car, plug-in electric vehicles, are analogous to automated vehicles. They may move in both directions, and the following occurs when you put the car in gear and step on the gas. The electric motor receives its power, which comes from the battery, via an inverter. When you press the gas pedal, a signal is sent to the controller, which then alters the frequency of the AC electricity going to the motor, changing the vehicle's speed. Through a cog, the engine can connect to the wheels and turn them. The motor converts into an alternator and recharges the battery whenever the brakes are applied or the vehicle speed decreases. Here's what all you need to know about the 2023 Toyota Corolla Cross. The 2023 Corolla Hybrid improves upon its illustrious forerunner by honing its ultra-efficient powertrains into one of the best-rated MPG automobiles in the entire business, easily outperforming the similarly fuel-efficient Honda Civic, Mazda 3, and Hyundai Elantra. For the 2023 model year, Toyota's added more trims to its hybrid-powered Corolla lineup while keeping some older trims out of production. With a base price of just under $24,000 and a maximum price of just over $27,700 for the fully loaded version, the base Corolla Hybrid is a fairly affordable choice that costs less than the base 2022 model. The 2023 Toyota Corolla Hybrid and its brother, the impending Corolla Cross Hybrid, place a heavy emphasis on efficiency at the expense of fun-to-drive dynamics, whereas other Toyota vehicles provide more variety in this regard. Let's look at one of the most fuel-efficient automobiles in greater depth. While most hybrid vehicles increase output by combining the power of the gasoline engine and the electric motor, Toyota's Corolla Hybrid utilizes a different approach. It's powered by a 1.8-liter inline-four engine that generates 134 horsepower and 156 pound-feet of torque. The Corolla Hybrid has two electric motors in front-wheel drive models and three in all-wheel drive models. To be clear, the Corolla Hybrid's electric motors don't contribute to the vehicle's total horsepower. Rather, they make the gas engine more efficient by reducing the amount of work it has to do. Therefore, the front-wheel drive Corolla Hybrid achieves an estimated 50 miles per gallon in the city and 43 miles per gallon on the interstate, while the all-wheel drive Corolla achieves 47 miles per gallon in the city and 41 on the highway. All Corolla models, including the hybrid, are equipped with a continuously variable gearbox that adjusts gear ratios on the fly for maximum economy. The Toyota Corolla is not a quick car by any stretch of the imagination because of the aforementioned operation of its hybrid powertrain. The LE, SE, and XSE can all be ordered as hybrids for the 2023 model year, and an all-wheel drive is a viable option for any of these grades. Now that we've gotten that out of the way, the Corolla hybrid all-wheel drive can reach 60 miles per hour in 9 seconds flat, while the front-wheel drive variant takes slightly longer. Keep in mind that this isn't the best vehicle to buy if you're in the market for something exciting and fun to drive. The Corolla Hybrid has relatively strong stopping power, and its regenerative braking system's very effective at filling the vehicle's battery, but the steering is imprecise and lightly weighted despite being reasonably responsive. However, the Toyota Corolla Hybrid's lackluster performance is more than compensated for by its excellent gas mileage. A new front fascia has been added, making the grille wider by connecting it to the side vents and canard cluster, and gloss black accents have been added to give it an intimidating look. The Corolla Hybrid's diffuser at the back has also been updated, and in addition, the Hybrid's only offered as a sedan, which, while offering less baggage space than the hatchback, provides better legroom for rear passengers. The 2023 Corolla boasts a roomy and plush interior that's outfitted with plenty of soft-touch materials like pliable rubbers and micro suede. An 8-inch infotainment display is standard on all Corolla Hybrid models, a digital gauge cluster, power-adjustable heated front seats, leather upholstery, and a 9-speaker JBL sound system are also available as add-ons. The Toyota Corolla Hybrid sedan has a much smaller trunk with just 13 cubic feet compared to the hatchback's 18 cubic feet when simply using gasoline. However, if you remove the spare tire as part of Toyota's free enhanced cargo space option, you'll gain 6 cubic feet of storage space. The 2023 Corolla Hybrid is an improvement over the 2022 model in several respects, including increased trim levels, an improved interior, and somewhat enhanced performance at the expense of marginally diminished fuel economy. The 2023 Corolla Hybrid is a fantastic option for anyone looking for a low-cost city runabout that won't skimp on efficiency. Moving forward, the 2023 Toyota Corolla Cross versus the 2023 Honda HRV. Both the Corolla Cross and the HRV have an abundance of active safety system standards. These include things like automatic emergency braking, adaptive cruise control, lane keep assist, lane departure warning, and blind spot monitoring. All LED headlights, keyless entry, automatic climate control, power windows, door locks, and mirrors are standard across the board. Steel wheels with plastic hubcaps come standard on Toyota's base model Corolla Cross L, while Honda's base model HRV rides on aluminum wheels varying in size from 17 to 18 inches. Both the HRV and the Corolla Cross have comparable optional features like sunroofs, leather upholstery, heated front seats, and more. The Honda's likely worth the extra money if you want a roomier cabin and a generally less dull experience, though we haven't tested the HRV yet. Assuming it preserves even a fraction of the Civic's energy, it'll be more pleasurable to drive than the Corolla Cross. But the Toyota has your back if you're looking for fuel efficiency and you're willing to give up some comfort and entertainment in exchange for monetary savings. This analysis may seem familiar because it's long been applied to the Honda Civic and Toyota Corolla. Nevertheless, it's now applicable also to the SUV siblings of those two automobiles. The current status of the EV plan for Toyota, as environmental groups like the Sierra Club and Greenpeace have criticized Toyota's plan, and for the past 2 years they've placed the Japanese automaker at the bottom of their auto industry decarbonization ratings. Over the next 9 years, Toyota aims to spend almost $70 billion on electrified vehicles, including $35 billion on battery technologies for fully electric vehicles. By 2025, it expects to have roughly 70 different electric versions available around the world. By 2030, Toyota anticipates selling around 3.5 million all-electric vehicles annually, which is about a third of its current yearly sales. So, let's go places with Toyota! This is the end of today's video. Please comment and let us know which car you liked more, and don't forget to like our video and subscribe to our channel.